Hi guys, and welcome to another video. Today I decided to film a little bit how I work in my darkroom. I decided to film it for you guys. So a lot of people from mostly the younger generation, my generation, can see how it is to work in a darkroom, because many people are scared to approach analog photography, especially developing analog photography, developing negatives and making prints and contact sheets. And so I wanted to show you guys today how I do it. It's important to say I'm not a professional photographer. It's just my hobby. I do it for fun. So everything I do can be wrong from a more professional point of view. My video shouldn't be taken as a main reference point for starting your own darkroom and starting your own development of negatives, but it maybe helps you a little bit in going into the right direction. And yeah, if maybe there are people watching this who already develop and print their own photographs, maybe tell me what you do different. What do you change about my darkroom work, and how in general how you like my darkroom work compared to yours? But yeah, let's go on now with the video. In the entire video, I didn't put a single measurement, precise measurement of the chemicals and the water. I only put the balance between chemicals and water. That's because it completely depends on your film, what type of film you have. I used Kodak, a TX400. But it works also in my case for Ilford HP5+, but it completely depends on what type of film you have. If you have 35mm film, if you have 120 film, how many rolls you develop, if you develop 2 rolls or 3 rolls at a time, and how big your development tank is. That are all factors that change your measurements. And so I only put the balance into the description of the video, because like this, you can see what the balance between the chemicals and the water should be. And for the measurements, there are plenty of websites from brands like Ilford or Kodak who tell you the exact measurements for which film and for how much film, and what measurements you need for how many rolls and for what film. Yeah, just go on their website and check it out and try to find the measurements of developing that suit your film best. Now enjoy how I show you how to develop black and white film negatives. Thank you. So now you have seen how to develop black and white film negatives. Now we are going on to making a contact sheet out of the negatives and taking the best photographs and making them into prints. Important to say is that also here I didn't include the balance of the chemicals because it totally depends of the size of your development tray. If you have a larger development tray, you need more chemicals than if you have a small development tray. And also very important to say is that the chemicals and the balances for the chemicals and the measurements are exactly the same for the contact sheet and for the actual prints of the photographs. Important to say is that the measurements I did on the f-stop on the enlarger machine itself and the time I exposed my negatives to light and my printing paper to the actual light of the enlarger completely depends on your own negative, so you have to figure that out yourself. And this is only how I did it in this specific case, but you gotta figure it out yourself. This was how you develop a contact sheet. Now we are going on to the prints. As I said, they are exactly the same balance and measurements as for the contact sheet. Just always remember to rinse your prints with water and to hang them to dry to get clean and proper results. And yeah, I would say, let's take a look at how you do a print. Thank you. It turned out pretty decent. So guys, that was the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys could learn something or take a little bit of inspiration from my darkroom work. Let me know if you're already an experienced photographer or an experienced darkroom worker, if you would change anything about how I work, or maybe found something interesting about how I do it. But yeah, for the moment, that's the video. I really hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions or any feedback about my videos. And yeah, see you next time.